shit. Here we go again.
Read, nigga! Read!
The Compound Effect by Darren Hardy. So I read the covers and the preludes and shit. Well, I didn't read this part. Just a bunch of best-selling authors glazing. And then you got that on the back. I read the back glazing. It was like, all right. Then you had this guy on top. He's probably one of the bigger things. 10-time best-selling author. He's like Post Malone. Wait, no. Post Malone went... Didn't he go diamond 10 times? Which is fucking insane. But yeah, anyway. A real program with real tools that could change your life and make your dreams a reality. David Bach. Is that the Spoonful guy? Yeah, I got a 10-year anniversary edition. This was a book given to me by my dad on Christmas. Thanks, Dad. Content. I think he was forced to read this at work. I don't know. He gave me this book, and then he started working on an AI t-shirt company on the side. So who knows what's going to happen to me. I just start snorting blow. Oh my God, the chat coin's exploding. What's next? NFTs. Let's go. No. Oh no. But yeah, I don't even think he's opened the book. Because it says this book is given to blank. It's given to nobody. See? And this is my dad. Because I care about Union Grid. He gave me this before he went to get the milk. And I just thought it was such a thoughtful gift. Then they have all this promo plugs. And then you're like, oh, this Darren Hardy guy. What is he, some quack? He's got websites for like free shit that you can do. They say free daily mentoring, which means he's just going to have videos sent to your email. But I don't know. He's got resources. I'm not really going to get that deep into it. I'm not trying to learn everything. I'm just trying to read a book. But yeah, he looks like a Bond villain. How could he not be successful? Look at him. 10-year life changes in print. Oh, yeah. RSS, yeah. Over 1 million copies sold. That's no small pickle. And let's see what else. Yeah. And not only was he on the New York Times bestselling book, Wall Street Journal bestselling book. I don't know why he didn't put that in the beginning. Wall Street Journal sounds a lot more interesting than New York Times. You know how many New York Times bestselling books I see? I swear to God, I feel like you can just like pay like a stamp to get like bestselling book. I swear to God. But anyway, that's not important. After all the glazing, and then it's dedicated to his dad and his mentor. The fuck is wrong with my kid? Jim Rohn. Anyway, they got this warning label. And it's like, oh my God, what is he going to say? Kids under 12 should not read this book? No, it's just saying, oh, it actually works, blah-de-da-de. I don't know. This is kind of corny, but whatever. And then you get a special message from Tony Robbins, which that is kind of insane. Tony Robbins, for those that don't know him, he's basically like one of the OGs in the self-improvement personal finance game. Let's say Darren Hardy was shit, I don't know. Let's say he's little baby. All right, this guy is Young Thug. Everyone's heard of Tony Robbins. If you haven't, then if you're getting into this scene, you will hear Tony Robbins. God, yeah. So Tony Robbins talking about, I like this book. Da 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 da. We had the same mentor. And then, like, yeah, he practically preach. He walks that talk. You know, he with it. You know, he's King Slime, blah-de-da-da. He had this thing called Success Magazine and everything. And then, let's see. I think they mock people that, like, give you bullshit, like gurus. You know, it's like those finance gurus. Like, I can change your life, girl. You know what I mean? It's like you'd get those annoying-ass ads. It's like, which one's more valuable? A house or a laptop or some guy talking about some shit with his rented Lamborghini. I don't fucking care how it took you to afford this Airbnb of a mansion because I know you don't own that shit. Miss me with the bullshit. And then it talks about 10 years. Like, I can't believe so many people got connected. This is awesome. Woody woo woo. And then introduction, we get the introduction, even though just talking about stuff and shit. And then he basically just kind of says the same thing Tony Robbins is, like, I hate to stroke my own, my own ego, but I'm that guy, you know? And then not only am I successful, I own a magazine and TV stations that talk about success. So I breathe in and breathe out success. That's how I would have worded it. I mean, it would have been quicker, you know, but then he talks about social media and then they just start talking about get rich quick schemes and how they're fucking useless. And then let's get started. The compound effect. There's going to be like, hold on. There's going to be like 6 chapters. I already looked in 3 simple steps. The next one thing, it's just blatant promo, you know, with a hashtag behind it. But no, I'm going to get in. I'm going to do conclusions and acknowledgments together when I review those. And I'm going to do a little chapter for each chapters, and I'll come back after each chapter. Damn, the blur is insane. All right, I'll be back. She give me the yes. All right, so I read chapter 1. So first off, he talks about his upbringing by his single father and how his dad's basically David Goggins and shit, just working his ass off, lifting weights. Yeah. And if I don't see bone, you get the man to work. And then he talks about, you know, how small things can really make or break you in some areas. He tells a story about this guy named, where the flibbity dibbity skibbity. Hold up. Ah, yeah. Let's see. Ba-ba-da-da-da. Yeah. You got this name, you got these guys named Larry, Scott, and Brad. Brad gets into cooking, and he's like, okay, good for him. Then he becomes such a fat ass, and then his life spirals out towards the end, and it's all depressing. And then you got this guy named Scott, who's on that self-improvement grind.
Knowledge.
And then, bam, he's just fantastic. And then there's another guy, I don't know, the third guy, he just stays the same, and he's a little bit bitter about it. One guy gained 33 pounds, another guy lost 33 pounds over, like, 31 months or something like that. And then, bam, he's just talking about consistency can either make or break you, and that's basically what the compound effect is basically about. So it might not seem like anything at first, but as time goes on, it will slowly and slowly, and then it'll just like ba da da da. The guy uses the would you rather have $3 million or a penny that doubles for 31 days example. It's saying, oh, you get more out of the penny than you would have the $3 million. I don't know. I feel like you win no matter what, so I wouldn't care, but I get what he's trying to say. It's just, I hate that analogy. And body to the, he's talking about society and how like some people that don't have it built in them, the you know, keep the continuous good habits and how it'd be their downfall, something like that. And then he adds onto his chart, choice behaviors and habits is what affects all this. So if you don't change, this thing don't change or something like that. If you're mid, you stay mid. If you get a little bit, if you do a little bad things, you get worse. You do a little bit good things, you'll get better. Boo-da boo boo. And then it talks about these summary action steps. Talk about like be like Scott, figure out some other things, and then try to prevent, think about things that are making you so worse, just bad habits, because bad habits will get worse. And that's how it explains it to you. I know I'm probably doing the poor job explaining it, but nah, this was a nice read part. I'm gonna get on to chapter 2 now. All right, I finished chapter 2, and this one basically he gives you more stories than these stories are more entertaining than chapter 1, and it's not that we're doing a comparison, but he just talks about how like how the smallest things in life, being consistent with them, even though they're bad things, good things, things you haven't done that are bad, things that you haven't done that are good, it all just stacks up, and like when you start and everything, it all just like impacts like where you'll be in the future a lot later and a lot closer, you know? Very interesting. You have some interesting stories. And then, yeah, this guy was talking about how he saved this guy's wife's relationship by writing down something about his wife that he liked every year. And then this guy was like saying I don't know, have problems with his wife or something like that. And then this guy was talking about how he probably had problems with his wife or something like that, you know? So he was writing something to appreciate his wife anymore, time goes on. And then at the end of one Thanksgiving, he gave like a journal to his wife, and then bam, he said she loved the gift, the author, and then the guy he told this to, he tries it out and it works for them, vice versa. I don't know if he gave the journal to the wife of his at that time. But yeah, it was cool. I mean, it kind of sounds like you're gaslighting yourself, but no, it lets you see the bright side of things. I thought that was cool. Very interesting.
just talk about if you just do like 1/10 of, you could do like the smallest thing, like you're trying to be better at like the smallest, like not even a full percent, 1/10 of a percent a day, and then bam, you keep it up, things will get so much better for you. And then he has this formula for going luck, because people say, oh, it's all luck. He's like, nah, we're lucky just being a free society. And then after that, it's all up to you. And then here is his equation for luck: preparation, personal growth, attitude, the gaslighting, no, opportunity. I think that's probably the biggest aspect of luck for people, because people get a lot of opportunity, myself included, and they'll just fumble. I fumbled so many things. As you know, you wake up and it's like, oh, and in action, doing something about it. This is probably going to be the toughest part for a lot of people. But anyway, preparation, you know, you're just on the grind, you're getting better at what you do, staying at it, boom, boom, boom. Attitude, you know, hey, you just got a good attitude with it. You know, none of that bullshit, you know. Opportunity is when you make the best out of that to come, or you can make opportunity happen just from like it happening naturally if you're doing the right thing. In action, this is when you strike when iron's hot, and then boo, boo, boo. And then he talks about like a failed business. And then another thing he talks about is like him like wasting his money when he first got into real estate, which is not a bad way to start getting money, you know. And it said it helped him be more frugal, understanding business wise and everything like that. And then let's see, yeah, after all that, he talks about how just writing down like one thing that you want to make in life. Like, let's say you're a fucking fat ass, right? You want to like stop being so fucking fat. Write down how much things you're eating. Nah, I'm not, it's not telling you to stop. It's just like, be aware, because you know, sometimes you'd be eating a whole bag of potato chips, you don't know it, you know. Sometimes you drink 9 beers and then you get pulled over, you forgot it was more than 2, you know. No. You know, and then shit like that. And it says you gotta start tracking. It's like, this is a cool thing. I'm not gonna do this just yet, because I'm just reading a bunch of self-help books, but I'll definitely be coming back to these books when I'm done. I mean, so far I read, like, this is my first time reading this one, but it's very interesting to look back at it. So I'll definitely be implementing a few things. I will not be using all the websites and shit. Nice thing about this book is that you don't have to use websites, but if you wanted to get, you know, knee deep into it, you can. But this book is helpful enough to say you don't have to do that. And then they give you the IRA example, like, oh, this is how much you spend money today. It adds up to a year. That year, boom, boom, boom. There you go. You could have had a down payment, but no, you were drinking that coffee, bitch. No, stuff like that. I mean, I guess, yeah, that's, it makes sense. But that's probably not like the biggest example of this. Then they talk about how much a golfer earns, and like, not because like this guy's like 10 times better than the number 10th guy. Look at that. Their difference is less than 1%. It's like a few hundreds of a difference. And look how much the payout this guy gets. This guy gets 4 million, fucking broke piece of shit. No, that's great, but you could have made more than double that. This guy made 10 million. Look at that. They're both under 70. It's fucking insane. And then he talks about how he improved people's life as secretary, and then he gave her some tips with a 40,000 year salary. He's like, I'll do you one better. I'll teach you how to be wealthy. I ain't giving you money though. It was like, it's smart for him. And I guess she was smart too, because she started making 100 grand a year, where it says right that, yeah, off her 40,000 base salary, and then she moved on to her own business, boom, 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 level up. And then, yeah, this is the IRA example. This person started doing 250 a year at the age 23, made a million, only spent, oh, my bad, made a million, only spent 54,000 over the whole time. You know, that's good. This guy started at 40. At that point, he's just a desperate call for help, but, you know, he tries, boom, 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 boom. He spent more than 30 grand, and look at that. He only got 1/3 of the example of that. That's 1/3 of the payout that she did, which is crazy, you know? And, he talks about someone's fitness journey, how it impacted her life, like just doing little things, and then she getting more into fitness, and boom, her life skyrocketing, you know, she's on boom, 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 business, everything. I'm saying boom a lot, am I? Yeah, I sound fucking stupid, I know. And then you get a summary, and it's like, yeah, just a loose summary, and it's like, hey, you can use my website. Plug. And it's like, yeah, use the website if you want to. But, yeah, this is cool. I mean, the summary is skippable, but I'm still read them, you know? because it's basically, you know, like a overall what happened, you know, with occasional plug and everything. So it's not bad. All right, on to chapter 3. All right, so it's a pretty big time jump from the last time I read the last two chapters. If I'm talking funny, this is like the first time I spoke today. I've just been reading for like the past 2 hours or something like that. I'm a slow reader. I get distracted easily. So, yeah, it doesn't really bother me though. You know, I'd rather get a quality read out of a quick read, if that makes any sense. So, this one talks about habits. And get into this chapter, you know, you get the typical tropes. He tells an interesting story. These stories are getting a little bit more interesting, I will say. The first one was kind of weird. He has all these examples, some little charts and comparisons that give you like the grand scheme, the big picture about things, right? But let's see. Okay, well, I'm not gonna get to that yet. And then you have this thing where he says, what's your big motivation? Because you're going to need more than motivation. You got your house. You know how to do this. Da, 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 or you don't. Your reason, you got to figure out why you want to improve yourself. Why you want to fix your troubles. Why you want to get these certain things in your life. Why you want this like fulfillment, this success, right? You find that and then you build off it. And it's just like an unseaging energy. I remember from the David Goggins book I read, the first one, he was talking about something similar like that. They correlate, if that makes sense, you know. So there's so much in this chapter. In this one, compared to the other chapters especially, he really deep dives on like the human habits and how it really affects your life the most, and like motivations and you know, I already said that, and like how like little things can affect you big, like in a big way. I got a note over here. We got some. I sound like I'm trailing, man. I'm just like, I mean, I'm ready to do some shit, man. Anyway, let's see. This was an interesting part that I just had to label, right? And let's see. One of my interviews with Brian Tracy, he brings up interviews all the time. That's another trope. Say it this way. Top people have very clear goals. They know who they are and they know what they want. They write it down and they make plans for its accomplishment. Unsuccessful people carry around their goals in their head, like marbles rattling in a can. And we say a goal that's not in writing is merely a fantasy. Everybody has fantasies, but those fantasies are bullets with no powder and cartridge. People go through life shooting blanks without goal, and that's just the starting point. That is fucking hard as hell, man. It makes you really put things into perspective, doesn't it? Like how much is something really of a goal? Or how, like, is it a goal or just something you fantasize about? If you really want to become a reality, why don't you write it down, put it into put it into a bigger focus, and just like not have it something that just escapes your mind after forgetting about it, and then just pops back randomly with like a heavy conscience. I thought that was very interesting. And yeah, like I said, there's a lot that goes on in the book. I'm doing a review, not a summary, so it's fine. Let's get parts. Another part that was interesting was this little chapter segment here. This was a loaded chapter. It took me a minute just to like, you know, to make sure I'm paying attention to. Let's see. The other two chapters were like 50, 49 pages, if we're being honest, combined. And then I had to read like two chapters worth in this one chapter. But there's a lot that goes on. It's very interesting. I will say I'm appreciating this book a lot more in this third chapter than the other two chapters. And this is, I mean, it's a really simple book to follow. I could tell you that. It's been a week since I last read the previous two chapters. I still understand everything that's going on in this book. You know what I mean? Kind of feels like its own sections is like dissecting this compound effect that he's talking about, right? And then he talks about something John C. Maxwell said. I don't know who that is, but it's a person that had success in your life, because he wouldn't be talking about them in this stature. John C. Maxwell said, you'll never change your life until you change something you do daily. The secret of your success is found in your daily routine. According to research, it takes 300 instances of positive reinforcement to turn a new habit into an unconscious practice. That's almost a year of daily practice. Fortunately, we talked about it earlier. We know much better. Chances to cement a new habit in our lives is after 3 weeks of diligent focus. You know, blah, 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 blah. But that was very interesting to learn about how, like, how many times you gotta do something where it can, like, stick in there. And then how consistency just, like, fixes up and changes that. And then it's all really interesting. I recommend that you read it yourself. This is a good book so far. I don't know what's with all the energy I'm having. I sound like a little ass kid. I'm fucking shaking my legs and shit. I'm not scared or anything. Don't be worried. I'm not getting fucking beat by fucking Italian mobsters. It's just I'm a little bit late on some payments. No, don't worry about that. I'm straight. And then so-and-so gives you all like these tips, and then these are like the longest part of books. They were interesting parts too, about there's like two or three sections that do something like that. But yeah, this is an interesting book. Even if you're not like putting this into like something where you're like reading it religiously and like putting it into deep practice, it really opens your mind onto some things. And I really appreciate that. It's very interesting. And so, yeah, I'm excited to get into this fourth chapter because it seems like it's just going to escalate into like certain things about diving deep in every chapter, which is really interesting. So, yeah, on to that. All right, just finished chapter 4. This man loves his analogies. So let's just talk about, you know, consistency, biggest key, because the more you keep doing it, the more you can get done with less effort. And then, basically, you know, the more you get towards it, the easier shit becomes, you know? Shit becomes easy for them. Then they gotta step it up, and then just, bam, that just becomes easy for them, too. That's basically what he's saying. If not, you gotta start over, and then, bam, you make no progress. You ain't really got to the point where you wanted to be, you know what I mean? I've reached that point lots of times. So you have. It's a common thing that happens among us. And then he talks about how, then compares, like, the momentum in our progress, like a locomotive. Like, if it doesn't move that much, if it's, like, still, and it's, like, not moving, it's not hard to stop it, right? You just put, like, a block of wood or something like that. But you keep that shit consistent, it can go through fucking concrete walls with steel and shit. Then he talks about his own schedule and how he, like, have a nice morning routine, a nice night routine, you know, to end off the night, and a few things he wants to keep consistent throughout the day, but throughout different times, so the day works different, but he still achieve all he wants to achieve throughout the week, the month, the quarter of the year, the end of the year. And then the things he's trying to aim for every time is called his most valuable priorities, MVPs, blah-de-da-da. Then he talks about how we get deluded and we got to think about the long-term goals instead of short-terms because we might set ourselves up for failure, you know? And he talks about how he's trying to, like, you know, work on a better relationship with his family and his wife and everything. And then he has this chart of, like, his weekly goals that he's trying to hit. And this is, like, example. You can download it on his website. Let me just find a website for you. Because I'm starting to get down with this website shit. I'm seeing the light now. You got so much shit in here, man. At darrenhardy.com/morningroutine. If you want to print that shit out, I might try do something with that. I'll not print it out, but I'll definitely use this example for journaling probably in the future, you know? I want a journal. I want a dream journal. I'm trying to lucid dream and shit. That sounds like fun. That has nothing to do with this. But yeah, it's just about momentum, keeping consistency up. You know, that's what I'm trying to do right now. You know, 2 days, read a book, try to start a gym routine, other things, you know, just stack upon it slowly but surely. And then I'm a beast, you know, that's how it'd be. Just trying to get my life together. This is a good book to read while trying to get my life together and work on the channel. So yeah, on to chapter 5, influences.
Look at that. Old me, the only thing I didn't make was the bagel, but I did put the cinnamon sugar coating on that. That egg, we ran out of pepper, but god damn, that sausage! You know I had to go. Ooh, shit, this looks good. I'm about to try this. Real good, man. Oh my. Get different angles, man.
So, the bagel. I didn't toast it long enough. I undercooked the bagel. I know I fucked up. Oh, shoot. Oh, well, whatever. I don't know why I'm making these weird noises. Anyway, I got sticky notes over here. I actually ripped out like a piece of text on the book. I gotta be careful where I place these from now on. But yeah, you know, let's just get some bigger Myers, see where he was spinning here. He was like talking about how like our mind tends to gravitate towards more negative things because that's just how our DNA was made as people, humans, you know. He says, and then he does this, you know, shameless plug. I know it's difficult to be consistent, positive, and abundant-minded source input each day. That's why I created Darren Daily. I write and record and deliver a 5-minute mentoring video every weekday. That is interesting. He does a 5-minute video every day. And then, you know, he got his website, and then you can, you know, download an assessment worksheet. This man's giving you homework with the book. And then he compares good thoughts and bad thoughts to, like, clear water to flint water, you know. And then he's talking about how, like, you know, what you decide to watch, like a bunch of news, shit, diet, horrible people will just affect you negatively, right? And you can't have negativity in your life, right? You know? And then, let's see. This must have been another one where you spent. Let's see. This was interesting what he's talking about. He was saying something about if you will do an audiobook every time in your car, that's like 300 hours worth of like information you do, something like that. And then that's like 2 years of like college or something like that. And then, yeah. And then he slides the promotion. It hasn't been like even 10 pages, right? By the way, if you want a podcast that will give you positive input you're looking for, check out Darren Daily On Demand, where you can listen to podcast episodes on DarrenDailyOnDemand.com.
Plug!
I listen to every episode. Not joking.
Oh my God, that's
fucking hilarious. And then he's talking about associations and, you know, how deeply people will influence you, even if you're not noticing it, right? It's like 95% is like something, I don't know. But it's basically like that, like that lunch table talk, like the five people you have lunch with affect how you are as a person or something like that. I don't remember much about that thing. I was deep into that like 2 years ago. Now I'm lost. Plug, you know. And then it's like there's three categories of like people you need to figure out your association with. Dissociation with, cut those fuckers off. No more contact. Get them fucking out of here. Limited associations. Realize there's people that, yeah, spend some time with it. But after a certain amount of time, why the fuck are you hanging with this person? It ain't even worth it. You know, they're not impacting something, or they're just ruining your whole vibe. They're ruining your mood. You know what I mean? It's all about getting the vibes right. Expand associations, people you need to like build like your bond deeper with and just your influence deeper with, you know, to talk about mentors, like, you know, people that can influence you, like people you could study basically, and then people you can meet and then go up here and shit, you know, raise it up. And then what I say on this one, it's this one. Oh, shit, man. I've spent more than 1,000 hours getting direct instruction from Jim. 99% of that was through books and audio programs. What's exciting about this is that no matter where you are in life, maybe busy at home with small children, take care of your old-ass parents, working long hours with fuckheads, dickheads, you know, the usual, with whom you have little common, or living out in the country, far from the nearest office building, you too can have almost any mentor you want. If he or she has their best thoughts gathered and stored, best thoughts, stories, and ideas in books, videos, podcasts, video, whatever, then you can draw your inspiration from there. And then he says, this is how the internet affects us positively. This is the advantage you can get from online. Real, you can, anyone you admire, you can get more from them. If they have the resources, look it up. And then it's talk about find a buddy to hold yourself accountable, and then you be accountable for that buddy. You know what I mean? It's always good to have a buddy, but you ain't got a buddy, then shit, work your way towards it. And yeah, he's talking about mentors, talk about people that he has in charge for specific things in his life, not just, he has a board of advisors for his life, not only just work, you know, personal trainers, coaches, shit like that. And then environment changes your perspective on things, you know, how you like you're just being the place that you might be like, that might be hindering like your thoughts on things, right? Damn, I didn't know my hand looked so hairy up so close. Damn. Anyway. And it says, sometimes you need to expand your horizons and you can realize how much bigger things you can do. Sometimes you feel like you can't achieve your dreams, but you go to places and then you can realize your dreams are actually achievable. Your dreams are actually achievable and shit like that. And then these past two pages, this man was spitting like crazy. I'm not gonna lie. He was spitting like crazy. I'm gonna go from here to here because you need to hear this, man. Put another way, you will get into life what you accept and what you are worthy of. If you tolerate this, I need to go back a little bit more. Okay, I'm reading three paragraphs. So yeah, these three paragraphs hit, man. Additionally, when you're creating an environment to support your goals, remember that what you get in life, you tolerate. This is true in every area of your life, particularly within your relationships with your family, friends, colleagues. What have you decided to tolerate that's also reflected in situations and circumstances in your life right now? And then, yeah, put another way, you will get in your life what you accept and expect you are worthy of. If you tolerate disrespect, you will be disrespected. Holy shit, man. If you tolerate people being late, well, I know, I'm not going to go too deep. If you tolerate your body being overweight, fat, and perpetually sick, it will be. It's amazing how life will organize around your standards you set for yourself. Yeah. Around the standards you set for yourself. Some people actually think they're victims of other people's behavior, but in actuality, they have control over how people treat us. Oh, we have control. I don't know what the... I'm getting the pronouns mixed up. Protect your emotional, mental, and physical space. Then you can live in peace rather than in chaos and stress the world will hurl upon you. That's some hard shit right there, man. I'll fuck with this one. You know, it's cool. And then you get like this little summary about it. And then bam, last one. Want to find a mentor? Luckily, I know a guy. Go to DarrenDaily.com if you are already subscribed. For free. It's for free though. So yeah, if it's really for free, check it out. Why not? You know? And then bam, another PDF. Okay. And now on to the final chapter. Alright, so I read the last chapter and the conclusion of the book. And basically, the end of this is just talking about how, along with consistency, do a little bit more than you think you could do, going past, you know, walls, mental, physical, you know what I mean? Other things and such, right? That's how you tend to get extra progress, man. Not just extra, you get to multiply, you get to go, you get to become exponentially more successful in that area as time goes on, you know? I don't know if I'm explaining that well. But yeah, it's no more than an improvement. It multiplies and just continues and continues. And then it's like, you know, you got two bunnies. You go on vacation for 3 years because, I don't know, you go on vacation for 3 years. It's not an example in the book. It's just something that popped in my head. What do you got? You got a whole colony. Shit, I don't even think you need... You probably have a whole country. Anyway, he brings out these examples of people that go through the most and, you know, surpass expectations of others. Always do more than you're expected. Even if it's just by a little, you'll tend to make a greater impression than what they expect. Anyway, here's another quote from the book. Where in life can you do more than expected? When you hit the wall or when you go for the wow? It doesn't take a lot more effort, but with a little bit, but little extra multiples and results many times over, whether you're making calls, servicing customers, organizing your team, acknowledging your spouse, going for a run, bench pressing, planning on a day, sharing your time with kids, whatever. What's the little extra you can do that exceeds expectations and accelerates your results? All right. And let's see. We got another one right here. He talks about how, you know, if you leave a good impression, you could be doing the most. And then, bam, they'll remember you. You know what I mean? And there's another quote from here. It's like, I was told once by a mentor, you may lose one out of the five for being too aggressive. My bad. But you get the other four. You can't be too aggressive. That's an interesting quote. So yeah, just to be better than expected, you know. Always surpass expectations, you know. That's another interesting thing to do. Then we get to the conclusion. And then he leaves a heartfelt message at the end of the book, which I think really will hit you if you read the whole book firsthand yourself. So I'm not going to read it a lot. I'm just going to read the beginning of this. Learn without execution is useless. I didn't write this book for my own amusement or simply to motivate you. Motivation without action leads to self-delusion. So yeah, there you go. You gotta put in this work. This is not a motivation book. This is a book to help you. This is more like a wake-up call and help you keep yourself going, man. You know, I think I left another note somewhere. No, that's it. It was a good book. It was a good-ass book. I enjoyed it. I give it an 8 out of 10. Hey. I just pulled up from the six, pulled up on your bitch. Hey, I just pulled up with a stick, flew under your shit. Hey, I just started off with shit, now I'm feeling rich. Hunky wanna hoe, brick, meet me at 906.